My name is Saurabh.
My name is Hani.
We are from Government Nehru College, Faridabad. We are from Botany Department. The topic of our module is bioremediation techniques. As we know, pesticides are very harmful for us, but it's a must need for farmers, and it protects their crops from insects, pests, and many other animals. So in this module we are trying to explain the various techniques how can we reduce the effect of pesticides in our daily life. First, I would like to draw your attention to the pesticide cycle. Here farmers is putting pesticide in the farmland. From the farmland it goes to the soil. From the soil it goes to the water. From there it goes to atmosphere by the process of evaporation and comes down in the form of rain and affect the aquatic life, animals and humans. And in humans it cause acute and chronic diseases. If I talk about acute diseases like nausea, skin irritation, and long term disease like cancer, also affect our kidneys and lungs. So the question is, how can we reduce the effect of pesticide in our daily life? The best method to treat the contaminated soil or water into good soil or water is bioremediation. Is the process of use of microbes to degrade the environmental contaminants in less toxic form. It is of two types, in situ and ex situ. In in situ form, we treat the contaminant at that place only. In ex situ form, we treat the contaminant in lab or laboratories. So, first is bioventing. Here, we provide direct oxygen to the microbes present in the soil so that microbes can grow and reduce the effect of a pesticide in that part. Now, second is bioaugmentation. In this technique, we directly add microbes to the soil so it can degrade the effect of pesticide in the soil. Now, third is biopiles. Here, we excavate the contaminated soil and arrange them in piles. And we, in this rich air collection system, we reduce the petroleum content in the soil, and we control the pH, moisture, heat, and provide oxygen to the microbes in that soil so that it can treat that soil. Now next is nutrient addition. Here we can directly add nutrient like nitrogen, phosphorus, phosphate, so that increase the fertility of soil. The next is land farming. Here we make a bed of clay or ash so that pesticide cannot reach out into the groundwater or the soil present below the bed. Now, six is bioreactor. It is a type of ex situ bioremediation. Bioreactor is a manufacturing system or a vessel that supports biologically active environment. Bioreactors are of six types. Here we make a model of fluidized bed bioreactor. Here I am providing oxygen to the bioreactor. Here is a pump and also added some minerals, chemicals and microbes in the soil. Here I am trying to show how can we treat contaminated water into decontaminated water.
There is also another method to reduce the use of pesticides, which is transgenic plants. In transgenic plants, we do genetic makeup of the plants so that plant have the resistivity to the pest and also some special characters which are generally not occur naturally in the species. Such type of example is Bt cotton. Bt stands for Bacterium thuringiensis. Here, Bacterium thuringiensis bacteria have a special character which is cry protein or cry gene. So we separate the DNA, we separate the genetic material of this bacteria and isolate the specific gene, and for the transmit, so we cut the TI plasmid from the Agrobacterium tumefaciens, and then by the help of endonuclease restriction enzyme we cut the plasmid and enter this specific character into the plasmid, and then enter the plasmid into the bacterium. Then the bacterium cell and plant cell are combined, and plant cell are grown in the culture medium, which is tissue culture, and thus it resulted into the pre-decotum. So how we separate the DNA? For separating the DNA, we have a process known as gel electrophoresis. In gel electrophoresis, as we know that DNA is negatively charged, so here two electrodes, one is positively charged and another is negatively charged. As we know that DNA is negatively charged, so that DNA move toward the positive electrode, and hence we can separate the specific character, specific gene or specific band of DNA. This is a bacteriophage. Bacteriophage is antibacterial virus. It attacks on bacteria and kill the bacteria. This type of bacteriophage, such as Wipro cholera, are found in Ganga river. So that Ganga is have its self-healing property. But now these days, Ganga's water are extremely used for drinking purpose and sewage treatment purpose, which is leads Ganga to its death. And also the people who lived near the bank of river Ganga are dependent for their farming, or they are dependent on water of Ganga, and also the water of Ganga increase the fertility of soil. So now the question is arise, how we increase the fertility. So if we protect the Ganga, we increase the fertility of the soil also. Thank you.